Okay. I'm going to post this on YouTube, but I'm working on recipe number 7, crispy chicken tenders and hot honey with potato salad and marinated cucumber. So I've chopped up almost everything. Cucumbers. I'm getting very good with the cucumbers now. Medium diced potatoes. And actually, my water is boiling. So potatoes are going in. How many minutes? Well, to 14 minutes. Okay, I can manage that. Let's set the timer. Also, I reconnected the smoke detectors, but I don't think one is actually connected because there's no light on it, but the other one is definitely connected. But I closed the bedroom doors, the fan is on, I opened the windows in the living room. So fingers crossed it doesn't go off tonight because I cannot deal with that nonsense again. It's like so grating. Okay, what am I doing with these? Thinly slice, separating the white bottoms and green tops. What? Oh, meaning the white part and the green part? Is that what that means? What are we doing with these at the end? Garnish the potato salad with the green tops. So where are the white tops? Ah, I was right. So the white part has to separate from the green part. Okay, I think I can manage that. And I'm actually used to cutting scallions because I make udon noodles, which are Japanese noodles, and they are always topped, or when I make them, they're always topped with scallions. Although, I mean, I don't think my knife is sharp enough to do the boop, 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 boop thing. I can't do that. So I have to go whoosh, 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 and like cut each time separately. Okay, so here's the white part in the bowl that's like way too big. You guys like my Mysterion shirt from South Park? Because I do. Perks from work. All right, now I have to cut the green parts. I guess I should invest in a knife that does let me do the boop, 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 boop thing. Although I'd probably still be too afraid to do that because I'm not a chef, obviously. But maybe I just need like a knife sharpener? That's a thing, right? I feel like I've seen that on Martha Stewart. My tiny little pink knife that's the only like super sharp knife that I have that works. So that's what I use whenever I have to like really cut things. Okay, the potatoes are doing something. It's not boiling again yet. But anyway, I really do like these Blue Apron meals because, especially for a single person, hey, what's up? You know, you don't waste produce. And I'm a little sad on the weekends when I don't have anything to cook because my box comes on Monday.
That's what she said.
And so usually I cook, you know, Monday. And depending on if I eat it for lunch the next day, I might cook Tuesday and Wednesday. Or if not, if I eat the dinner Monday, Tuesday, then Wednesday, Thursday, then I'll cook Friday. So Friday would be like the latest that I would be cooking anything. So, you know, over the weekend, I'm sad. But I did cook another steak, a ribeye, a giant ribeye. It was like this thick. It was crazy. I had to consult Tara for how many minutes on each side in the pan, and she said 11 to 12. And it was delicious. It had so much fat. I told the guy, I was like, give me the one with tons of fat. And it was like $20, which is ridiculous. But it was delicious. And ever since I started doing Blue Apron, I'm like, I don't want to like shop at Stop and Shop because I feel like certainly the proteins, but just the produce in general, is like total poop. You know what I mean? So I got the steak at Fresh Market, which is, I think it's a chain, but anyway, there's one near me. It's like a step up from Stop and Shop. Like, I definitely always buy my proteins there because they have a whole section and it's like really good. Okay, hold on, let me do this. Sherry vinegar hot sauce. Oh god. No hot sauce for me. Okay, half the vinegar to the bowl of cucumber. So like, I can't see what's in there. Can't see. What was I saying? Oh yeah, Fresh Market. It's kind of like a step up from Stop and Shop, but not as like crazy as Whole Foods, because Whole Foods is like insane. Okay, drizzle with olive oil. I can do that. Salt and pepper. That's another thing I've learned through this. They have you salt and pepper all the time. Presumably because you really have to put like a lot of salt and pepper or like a lot of salt to make it like salty as opposed to just like seasoned. And same thing with pepper. Like I can't eat spicy, but pepper's not, it's not like spicy. It just gives it some flavor. Okay, so what are we doing? Mixing it up. Set aside to marinate, stirring occasionally for at least 10 minutes. See, season with salt and pepper to taste. Again, transfer to a serving dish. Well, this is the serving dish, I hate to tell you. We don't have platters in this house. I mean, I do, but it's just me, so let's not get crazy. Ooh, man overboard. I'm gonna eat it, even though I probably just ate some, like, cat hairs from the floor. Ooh, that tastes good. Look at them. Halved lengthwise and then thinly sliced. And I remember to take out the seeds before I started slicing. Last time I forgot to do that. So that was fun. Okay. Cook the potatoes. Drain thoroughly and return to the saucepan. Add the quark cheese. What is that? Ooh. Quark cheese. Mayo, blue apron mayo. Okay, let's pile these up. White bottoms, and remaining vinegar. Okay, I can do that. So all of this crap on the paper towel, it's waiting on the paper towel, is gonna go in the potatoes when they're done. We have 6 minutes and 40 more seconds, I think. Although I kind of small dice these. I think they're small dice, not quite medium diced. But hey, potatoes are potatoes and they'll be delicious. Okay, so let's deal with chicken now, right? While the potatoes cook, bread the chicken. Chicken, where are you? Here's my chicken. And I say this every time, but the proteins that they send are delicious. They really are. All right, what are we doing? Crack the egg into a medium bowl. They even sent an egg. I can't. Brown eggs. See, I prefer brown eggs too. I'm gonna recycle everything. So I always have like a pile of everything everywhere. Season with salt and pepper and beat until smooth. I'm not gonna say that's what she said again, even though I could. No. I need eggs this morning. Oh no, I'm having more eggs. That's bad. Oh, no wonder my cholesterol is so high. Okay. Oh my god, it's so funny to beat one egg. It's like nothing. Place the flour and matzo meal in two separate medium bowls. Oh god, we're doing assembly line. Oh, okay. I like to use these, like, flat bowls for that. Okay, matzo meal. Interesting. I usually use, mandake. What's it called? The Japanese breadcrumbs. I'm totally blanking.
all-purpose flour, right?
Yes. You know what I'm saying. I have some in there. I could go look, but I'm just eating. Panko, or as Americans say, panko. But in Japanese, it's panko. So this will be interesting. We're using matzo meal. Okay, I have to save, like, everything. Everything can be recycled. Okay. So, it's going to be egg, flour, matzo meal, correct? Season each with salt and pepper. Oh, all right. I'm going to do these with salt and pepper, too. Interesting. And then you know you're going to have to salt and pepper the meat, too, which is, like I said, just more and more flavor. Okay, taters have maybe 4 more minutes or less. We'll see. I think this is smooth. Okay, chicken. I never know if, like, the sides come apart. I just cut into it with a knife because I figure that's the easiest way to get to it. Nothing broke. Paper towels. Right?
Is that what you're gonna say?
Pat the chicken dry with it. Yeah, salt and pepper on both sides. See, I already know what they're gonna say. I have to say, after doing 6, this is my 7th now. I can kind of guess what they're going to say now, especially with the proteins. It's always like pat it dry, salt and pepper, which makes sense. And I can kind of plan better because, I mean, they do give you, oh, this chicken's like partly still frozen. They kind of give you, I mean, they do give you the directions in order, but like sometimes, like, I don't always look ahead and then I'm like, like, it'll say to boil water is, like, the first thing in prep. But if it's, like, especially if it's, like, a small pot, I know it's going to start cooking or it's going to boil within, like, a couple minutes, and whatever's supposed to go in there isn't going to be ready. So I always look to see what's going in the boiling water, so I dice that up first, even if it's not what it says in the directions. Okay, let's salt and pepper this chicken. Damn, I'm running out of pepper. I actually need to get, new, what do they call, grinders or mills? Becky and Chris had really nice ones that I have to get. They're a little pricey, but they're like really nice. And honestly, when I was like doing this and grinding, like, you could really feel and see the difference in like what was coming out. Know what I'm saying? I know, I wash my hands a lot. I'm crazy. Okay, so chicken, I'm gonna need something to put this on, right? And I just put it on a giant plate. Bread the chicken, working 2 pieces of 3 coats, seasoned chicken with flour. Oh, right, flour's first. Then chicken. I mean, then egg, matzo meal, pressing to adhere, transfer to a separate plate. So I'm gonna do this. Wait, I don't want to put it on the stove because the stove is hot. I need a bigger kitchen! Hashtag first world problems. Here's my chicken. They're in little tenders. Little strips. Really? 2 at a time? Okay, if you say so, I'll do 2 at a time. You want to see my exciting chicken? 2 at a time. Boop, boop. Boop, boop, boop. There you go. I love this. I love that they give you the precise amount. It really, I know I've said it like 100 times, but it really just makes such a difference. Because I never know how much, so I probably put too much, you know? And then I end up wasting. Oh, potatoes! Look at that. Wow, that coating is really, oh damn, I'm gonna waste the coating on my fingers. Taters. I'm assuming you're cooked. right? Do I have to, like, pierce one? Let's just be sure. God forbid they're not hooked. I'll be mad. Oh! Good. Probably overcooked. That's okay. I don't mind. Let's use an oven mitt so I don't burn. What do I do with those? Drain thoroughly and return to the saucepan. Okay. So I need this saucepan to stay in action. Okay, we'll deal with that in a second. I'm gonna let them dry for a second. Let's do this chicken so that I can get all the goop on my fingers in one fell swoop. This matzo stuff is like, oh, you know what? I didn't mix it up. So I probably have all the salt and pepper on those first two. Oops. But yeah, the chicken that I had week one was super tender and delicious. You know, last week there were these beef pitas. I was not a huge fan of those. I mean, they were good, but, like, you were supposed to make this marinade with tahini, which they provided. And I don't think I did anything wrong because it was just tahini and, like, lemon juice. But mine turned into, like, a paste. It really wasn't a marinade. So it was just kind of, like, you were supposed to, like, whisk it together. But it all just kind of stuck together. And then the beef was, like, supposed to be strips, but it was really, like, one giant, like, ball of beef. So, you know, and I took them apart, whatever, but it really wasn't strips. It was more like chunks, which I guess doesn't matter for the purpose of the pita and for cooking. It was fine. And then it had, like, the cucumbers to go in the pita, and then there was like a radish, something, snap peas. Oh, that's my other complaint, the snap peas. I don't really understand how to take out that hard string in the middle, because sometimes when you snap off the end, that piece comes off, and sometimes it doesn't. So like, when it doesn't, what are you supposed to do? So then when I ate them, I had a lot of those stringy things, and I'm not a huge radish person, so I was kind of like, meh. So, whatever. I mean, it was still good, obviously, better than anything I would have made by myself. Oh my god, I have so much stuff on my hands now. Oh, I only have one piece left. Okay. I bet this is going in the pan, so that will be the smoke detector test. Working. Cattle. Okay, my head's cut off, sorry. Alright, so let's put these potatoes back in the pan per instructions. And then we'll add in, let me do this last piece of chicken real quick. So this is supposed to be like 35 minutes total. Okay, I think I've already passed that. But that's okay. Getting it done. Better late than never. Okay. This looks good. This chicken looks good. I'm excited. It's matzo. Just pressing it, pressing it. Press, press, press. Okay. So, I'm gonna get this matzo off. Okay. Well, while the potatoes continued cooking, yeah, I finished the potatoes, people. So we're adding all of this, right? the vinegar, the white, scallions. Salt and pepper. This is so cute. Ooh, mayonnaise with black pepper. Yum. Add that in. Need the spatula. Boop. Yum. Sorry, I can't show you. I can't move the thing and cook at the same time. Maybe one day I'll have a little camera system in my apartment. Burnt cheese. This is so interesting. Hi, Boo Boo. This is not for you. Oh, it's almost mealtime for you. That's why you're starting to beg. 8:30. She knows every night and every morning. I don't know how cats know. They have a clock. Vinegar. Okay, let's mix this up. Oh, it's kind of hot. Oops, I'll show you though. Oh no, So we're mixing all that up. It smells really good. Actually, mostly I just smell garlic, but that's okay. I mean, garlic, vinegar. But that's okay. I'm assuming. Okay, that needs salt and pepper. You like my Hello Kitty mitten? Okay, and then we're just putting that aside, correct? Medium nonstick. Here we go. Time to see. Did I put this away? If the if the smoke detectors go off, this will be the true test of time. Heat a thin layer of oil on medium high until high. Yeah, medium high means medium, otherwise I burn my apartment down. Let's see. Okay. I think that's enough. That was enough oil. Let's get rid of all non-recyclables. Items. So these are done. Egg, mock meal, and flour. See, and even that tiny bit there was a bunch left over. Oh god, I forgot to stir the cucumbers! Tragedy! Oh, man overboard. I'm eating it. Too bad. These can go away. Oh, towel. I didn't use this. This can go away. Okay, so the chicken. Cook the chicken. Let's add a... Oh no! Add a pinch of matzo meal. Oh, that's just to test it. That's okay. Add the breaded chicken and cook 3 to 5 minutes per side until golden brown. Cooker. If the pan seems dry, add a drizzle of olive oil. Okay, I can do that. Transfer to a paper towel lined plate. I'll just use the one that I have. That's it. Okay. And then doing something with the other items, the potato. I need to stir this more. That's good to know. So if I want to make like a little potato salad, I now know that I just need 2 potatoes. Okay, I need the place to put cooked chicken. Actually, I think I'll be able to do it. Excuse me while I hoist up my jeans. While the, so I think I could put most of the tenders in at one time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So
So I think I could fit them all in there, which means I can use the plate that I use for that. Should dry them.
I'm just rinsing out recycling. Oh my god, I'm so hot. I'm sweating. Okay, cubes. Okay. While the chicken cooks in a bowl, combine the honey and up to half the hot sauce, depending on how spicy you'd like the dish. Not spicy, that's going in the recycling. Divide the cooked chicken between two dishes, garnish the potato sauce with the green top, serve with marinara and hot honey on the side. Okay. So basically, the honey is just for the chicken, so I'm just going to put that aside, like in a little bowl, probably. In like a tiny Japanese bowl, because only Japanese people make tiny bowls. I shouldn't say only, but Japanese people make tiny bowls. And they're very useful in situations like this. Okay, vinegar's done. I am tossing the hot sauce because God is not like hot sauce. Yay! Okay. I don't think the oil is hot yet. Let's drop some water. Oh, Pixie's stalking because it's 8:31. And she hasn't eaten yet. Oh no, the honey might be too hard because it was just in the box. It's supposed to get room temperature. Well, at least it's in like paper. It's in like a cardboard thing. So they are very conscientious. And like all the packaging, like the box and the ice packs and stuff, that's all recyclable too. And the silver, like, crazy foil bag thing that everything comes in. All right, hopefully that'll start to, it's a little hard. Boo Boo, get down. She's not allowed on that side, but. Okay. I think chicken could be ready, let's see. Oh, you get to look at my washer and dryer. How exciting. It wasn't that hot. Let's leave that one for a second then. Oops. I turned the volume up a touch just to get it going. What else are we doing with this potato salad? I definitely overcooked these potatoes, but that's okay. I'd rather they be overcooked than undercooked. What are we doing with the... Oh, it says transfer to a paper towel lined plate, immediately season with salt, even after it's cooked. Season with salt. Interesting. Oh, right. Green tops of the scallions go with the, I'd say we do 3 minutes because these are like really thin. Thin pieces of chicken. I'm still here. Let's get out the plate that I'm going to eat with. What do you think about that? It's not that much, but I guess I'll use the giant plate. Okay, my knife and cutting board can go away if I can pick them up. And my tongs. Yeah, you definitely use like a lot of utensils. Like, I've actually been using my dishwasher, which normally I never use my dishwasher because it would take me like a week to fill it up. And I use like the same stuff every day. Okay, that might need more. Two. So it's only 1 minute, so it's been 4 minutes. Math is hard. so stupid. Okay, I think we're in good shape. So, let me taste the potato salad. That's good. I'm gonna add a little more salt and pepper. I like the vinegar. I forgot about vinegar and potato salad. It'd be delicious. I don't know if this is gonna last. No, I have to save it. I've been really good. I haven't had more than one portion. I've always had just the one. But it is a good amount of food. I thought like I would be able to eat two portions, but it's really like plenty. Okay, the oil was totally not hot enough for the chicken. Oh well. You're still really trying to get all the honey out. You're still thin, so it'll cook quickly. I feel bad recycling this though. It has honey in it. You stay over there. Oh, let's put some of the green scallions on top of the potato salad. Then I'll save the rest for tomorrow. All right, we're getting there. I don't think it needs more oil. Oh, we're doing anything with the cucumbers? Oh, the cucumber's on the side. But you know what? I'm just going to leave it in the bowl, and I'll just eat half. I'll just guesstimate with my vision how much is half. All right, that's pretty much it. I've got the honey on the side for the chicken. That's kind of cooking. I also have the window open, and the wind keeps blowing, so I think that's... But I can't close the window because... stupid smoke detectors, and also I'll like sweat to death and die. Minute 30. This part is taking longer and boring. I can show you the cukes and the potatoes with the scallions. Potatoes, scallions, cukes, honey. We're ready to go. Sorry, boo boo, I'll feed you soon, I promise. 8:37, she's probably in a panic. Don't judge me, I'm not wearing makeup. I'm sure you could tell. 54 seconds. Oh, I should play music. Then you probably can't hear me.
Maybe you would prefer that.
Yummers. These really are chicken tenders. They're so cute. Just like the picture says. Although I feel like it looks bigger and you can tell that I totally did not medium dice the potatoes. Mine are tiny diced. Tiny diced potato salad. But like I said, I don't really care. I'm sure it tastes good. Okay, getting ready to turn. I hope they're good. I don't want to turn the heat up anymore because I'm afraid of what's gonna happen. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Oh, they are golden brown. They look good. So I say 4 minutes and then we'll check it to see how they look. I need paper towels. Oh, now I can't use this plate. I thought I could use the same plate that I had the chicken on, but I'm just gonna put it on the counter. I don't care. I don't need a whole nother plate to wash, just to rest the cooked chicken that I have to put salt on. Don't forget. Salt. Honey. I'm excited. This looks good. I'm hungry. All right. Well, I'm just going to show you the chicken because I feel bad making you wait, but I think, oh, sorry. I think we're in good shape. Golden with the matzo. So, honey, so number 7 is a success. I'm excited, I'm happy. I'm learning how to cook. Okay, bye.